Okay. Ujjwal Nikam, can that be done legally speaking? This was a judgment given by the highest court of the country, the Supreme Court, back in 1996. There was apparently a review petition filed as well by a certain NGOs, which was again dismissed by the Supreme Court. Can the government of India, because it's a plaintiff in this case, approach the Supreme Court once again for a review of that judgment?
No, it is now next impossible for the simple reason there is an inordinate delay in filing the review petition, because the CBI has already lost that option. Mr. Lal, in fact, ought to have, when now he is alleging that there was a pressure, then why did he succumb to that pressure? This is the first question. And mm-hmm. if he acted under the pressure, then he is equally guilty in the eyes of the law. This is second.
Jacob,
and
third
aspect.
Like to intervene here. It is necessary.
Third aspect.
No, I did not.
No, you got your chance, no, Mr. Lal. You got your chance to respond. Let Mr. Nikam finish his point.
Third thing.
Yes, go on, Mr. Nikam.
Third thing is that now to approach again to the Supreme Court after the gap of 25, 26 years.
Okay.
Supreme Court won't admit that plea of, you see, reviewing the matter. Now the judgment is already over. Now that
right.
option is already foreclosed.
Can I say something? He's saying something.
Rasha Digra, let me get a closing comment from you. Now that Mr. Nikam has said that legally speaking, it would be foolish for the government of India to go back to the Supreme Court asking for a review of the judgment, will there be a sense of closure at all to this case, or will this simply be one of the biggest farce that we've seen in our time?
I just want to say that the charges against Warren Anderson have not been diluted.
Mr. Lal, one sec. Let Rasha Digra finish her point and then I'll come back to Mr. Lal. Rasna, finish up.
I'm just saying that the charges against Warren Anderson have not been diluted. The charges against Warren Anderson are still under Section 304, Part 2, which is culpable homicide. Only the charges against Indian officials were diluted, and it is very hard to go back to file a review petition. So there is still a lot of chance. 304, Part 2 is covered in the extradition treaty. We can still get him here. Please do
you
not
You still believe that the government of India will do all it can to extradite this man, and that this man will be brought to India, tried in an Indian court? And convicted.
If there is political will, yes, they can bring him. If they can bring Abu Salem, if they can go and interrogate Hedley,
right.
Yes, if there is political will, everything is possible. But there has to be.
B.R. Lal, closing comment from you, yeah, because you are a former CBI officer, very closely associated with this case. Is it easier said than done, extraditing Warren Anderson?
I think comments of Mr. Nikam are misplaced because of his ignorance. We never got pressurized. It is a different thing. That letter came, we just ignored it. We did not act on it. We represented back to the ministry. He has not listened to me. I briefed the DLA in details. I wish that he takes cognizance of this before reacting, and does not react in the dark.
Okay. This debate will go on. For the moment, though, I want to thank you all for joining us on Center Stage tonight. Ujjwal Nikam, Mr. B.R. Lal, Rasna Dhingra, Prakash Javdekar, and of course Moti Singh, the former DM of Bhopal, for joining us on Center Stage. Clearly, if the government needs to show that it's serious about getting some semblance of justice for the victims of Bhopal, the least they can do is to start with a compensation, and more importantly, look at what all legal avenues that they have open now, both in terms of strengthening the charges and enhancement of sentence to those who have been convicted by the lower court in Bhopal, and also how they can pursue, even at this late stage, if at all, the extradition of Warren Anderson.